In today's class, we are continuing with our lesson solutions. Okay. In the previous class, we stopped with the colligative properties. I wrote the names of the colligative properties alone. Okay. So, what are the names I wrote? Relative lowering of vapor pressure, depression in freezing point, elevation in boiling point, osmotic pressure. So, we will start the first colligative property. I told you what is colligative property. It depends on the number of solute. Okay, number of solute means it depends on the molar mass of the solute. Okay, so first we will derive the first colligative, do the derivation for the first colligative property, relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, so first I am going to take a solvent. Okay, that solvent's vapor pressure, the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, I am going to take it as P10. Always remember, first component is the solvent, second component is the solute. So that also, if you want, you can note it down. First component is my solvent and second component is my solute. Okay, so the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, I am taking it as P10. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to add solute to the solvent. The solute is added to the solvent. If I add solute to the solvent, what I will be getting? I will be getting the solution. Yes or no? So this vapor pressure of the solution, I am keeping it as vapor pressure of the solution, I am keeping it as P1. Okay, so what is the vapor pressure of the solvent? P10. After adding the solute, it will become solution. So, vapor pressure of the solution is P1. Okay. So, always the vapor pressure of the solvent will be greater than the vapor pressure of the solution. So, vapor pressure of the solvent will be greater than vapor pressure of the solution. Vapor pressure of the solution. This I have already explained. Okay. So if I take the solvent, means in the surface only the solvent molecules will be there. Yes or no? So everything will change into vapor and everything will be giving the vapor pressure. But if I take the solution, what will be there? Both solute and solvent, both the particles will be there on the surface. Only the solvent will be changing into vapor and it will give vapor pressure. So here there will be more vapor pressure, here there will be less vapor pressure. So this I have already explained. So the change in vapor pressure, delta P1. The change in vapor pressure, delta P1, is equal to, which is the greater value? P10 is greater, P1 is lesser. So change in vapor pressure, I am writing it as P10 minus P1. P10 minus P1. But we have already studied in Raoult's law. What did we study in Raoult's law? According to Raoult's law, we studied P1 is equal to P10 into S1. So this, if I substitute here, what I will get? Delta P1 is equal to P10. Instead of P1, I am substituting P10 X1. So P10 I can take commonly outside here. Yes or no? So I will get delta P1 is equal to P10 into 1 minus X1. And one more thing we already know. We already know that the sum of the mole fractions, X1 plus X2, will be always equal to 1. So what is x2? 1 minus x1. Yes or no? So instead of 1 minus x1 here, I can substitute x2. Okay, so what I will get? Delta P1 is equal to P1 naught into x2. I will be getting P1 naught into x2. Now bring this P1 naught this side. If this is multiplication here. So if it comes this side, what will happen? It will become division. So what I will be getting? Delta P1 divided by P1 naught is equal to x2. I will be getting like this. Yes or no? So delta P1, the formula already we have written here. What is the formula for delta P1? P1 naught minus P1 divided by P1 naught is equal to x2. So what is x2? Mole fraction. So mole fraction formula already we have studied. We know that mole fraction of the second component is equal to number of moles of the second component divided by total number of moles. So this I have to substitute here. So if you substitute here, what I will get? P1 naught minus P1 divided by P1 naught is equal to N2 divided by N1 plus N2. I will be getting. Okay. Suppose if I consider N1 is very much greater than N2. If I consider N1 is very much greater than N2, then I can write N1 plus N2 approximately as N1. So what will happen to the equation? P1 naught minus P1 divided by P1 naught is equal to N2 divided by N1 I can approximately write it as N1. So what is N? N means number of moles. Yes or no? So number of moles, what is the formula? Mass by molar mass. So number of moles of 1 will be mass of 1 divided by molar mass of 1. Okay. So W is the mass. M means molar mass. So number of moles of 1 will be mass of 1 divided by molar mass of 1. So what will be N2? Mass of 2 divided by molar mass of 2. So instead of N2 and N1, I am going to substitute these two in this formula. So what I will be getting? P1 naught minus P1 divided by P1 naught is equal to, instead of N2, I will be getting W2 by M2 divided by, instead of N1, I will be getting W1 by M1. So if it goes that side, it will become reciprocal. So P1 naught minus P1 divided by P1 naught is equal to W2 by M2 into, this will become W, sorry, M1 by W1. So from this I can calculate what? M2, molar mass of the solute. That only we will calculate, yes or no? So from this M2 can be calculated. So understood? So this is my derivation for relative lowering of vapor pressure. Understood? Take up. So the second colligative property is elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point. So elevation in boiling point means what? Boiling point is elevating. Elevating means what? It is increasing. Boiling point is increasing. So first I am going to consider my boiling point of a solvent. Boiling point of the solvent, I am going to take it as TB naught. Okay. So when I add solute to this solvent, what will happen? It will become solution. So boiling point of my solution. Boiling point of solution means what? After adding the solute, the boiling point will become TB. am going to take it as TB. Elevation in boiling point means what? Boiling point is increasing. So the change in the boiling point will be equal to, boiling point is increasing means what? So first the solvent will be there. After adding the solute, the boiling point will increase. So TB value will be more than TB naught value. So change will be TB minus TB naught. Okay. So that means what? After adding the solute, the boiling point increases. The boiling point increases. Understood? So delta TB is equal to TB minus TB naught. So solution's boiling point will be more than solvent's boiling point. Okay. Now, according to some experiments, this delta TB is directly proportional to M. So M means molality of the solution. Molality of the solution. Molality of the solution. So delta TB, that means what? Delta TB means what? Elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point is directly proportional to molality of the solution. So to remove the proportionality sign, I should add one constant. So delta TB is equal to, I am adding the constant KB, KB into M, KB into M. So this KB is called as the proportionality constant. KB is the proportionality constant. So the name of this proportionality constant is boiling point elevation constant. What is the name? Boiling point elevation constant. Boiling point elevation constant. Or it is also having another name called molal elevation constant. Molal elevation constant. Or it is also having another name called ebullioscopic constant. Ebullioscopic constant. So understood? So this KB is proportionality constant, or boiling point elevation constant, or molal elevation constant, or ebullioscopic constant. So this equation I am keeping it as 1. So from this, can I get the formula for KB? What will be KB? KB is equal to delta TB divided by M. So what will be my unit for KB? Unit for KB. So this is boiling point. Boiling point means temperature. Temperature unit is Kelvin. Molality. What is the unit for molality? Moles per kilogram. This is my unit for molality. We have already studied. Okay. Moles per kilogram. So if this moles and kilograms comes to the numerator, what will be my unit for KB? Unit for KB will be Kelvin. Mole, if it comes to numerator, it will become mole inverse. Kg, if it comes to numerator, it will become Kg. Okay. So now, what is the formula for molality? Molality formula, we know, number of moles of the solute divided by mass of solvent in kilograms. Mass of solvent in kilograms. This is my formula for molality. So M is equal to number of moles. Number of moles means N. Number of moles of the solute. Solute means, I told you, it is the second component. N2 divided by mass of the solvent. Mass means, I will use the term W, because M I am using for molality. So for mass I will use the term W. Mass of the solvent. Solvent is which component? First component. Mass of the solvent in kilogram means divided by 1000. So understood how I got this 1000? Because it is in kilogram. So what is the formula for number of moles? Number of moles is equal to mass by molar mass. So number of moles of 2 means mass of 2 divided by molar mass of 2. Okay. So this you substitute here, what I will get for molality? W2 by M2 divided by W1 divided by 1000. So M will be W2 by M2 into 1000 by W1. I will be getting like this the formula for molality. So this is 2. This 2 I am going to substitute in this first equation. So substitute 2 in 1. So I will be getting delta TB is equal to KB into, instead of M, W2 into 1000 whole divided by M2 into W1. So always we will be calculating M2 only. So bring this M2 this side, delta TB you take it that side. I will get M2 is equal to KB into W2 into 1000 divided by delta TB into W1. So this is my formula to calculate the molar mass of the solute if there is elevation in boiling point. Okay, so this I can represent with the help of a graph. Okay, so I will be drawing a graph like this. So in the x-axis I am taking temperature in Kelvin, and in the y-axis I am taking vapor pressure. Okay, so which will have more vapor pressure? Tell me. Which will have more vapor pressure? Which will have more boiling point? Yes, that solution will be having more boiling point. So solution's boiling point will be here, this side, and solvent's boiling point I will be getting this side. Okay, suppose if you take the same vapor pressure, in the same vapor pressure, if you see the solvent's vapor pressure, solvent's boiling point will be less, so TB0 will be less, and the solution's vapor pressure, boiling point will be higher value. Same vapor pressure, la, I am seeing the boiling points. In the same vapor pressure, the TB0 means what? Solvent's boiling point will be less, solution's boiling point will be more. So when I subtract these two, I will be getting delta TB. This delta TB only is called my elevation in boiling point. Okay, so you must write this is solvent, this is solution. Okay, this is solvent, that is solution. So understood what is elevation in boiling point? Take down. Coming to the third colligative property, depression in freezing point. Depression in freezing point. Okay, so depression in freezing point, that means what? Freezing point is depression. Depression means it is decreasing. Okay, so here also for solvent, I am going to take the freezing point. For solvent, I am going to take the freezing point as T. This is freezing point, so I am going to take as TF0 for the solvent. Okay, so for the solution, after adding solute, what will happen? It will become the solution. So for solution, I am going to take the freezing point as TF. So depression in freezing point means what? The freezing point is decreasing. That means what? After adding the solute, the freezing point will decrease. After adding the solute, the freezing point will decrease. So when the solute is added, the freezing point decreases. The freezing point decreases. Understood? So how much it is decreasing? The change in freezing point, delta Tf. So this delta Tf is called as the depression in freezing point is equal to, which is my larger value, Tf naught is my larger value, Tf naught minus Tf. Okay, so if by experiment we already know this delta Tf is directly proportional to molality. So to remove this proportionality constant, I will be adding a proportionality constant. So boiling point means I added Kb. So freezing point means I will be adding Kf into m. Okay. So this Kf is the proportionality constant. It is called as freezing point depression constant. Freezing point depression constant, or it is called molar depression constant. Molar depression constant, or it is called cryoscopic constant. So these are the three names for this Kf. So this I am going to keep it as equation number 1. So what will be my Kf value? Kf is equal to delta Tf divided by m. So what will be my unit of Kf? Delta Tf means freezing point, temperature, Kelvin. Molality, the unit is moles per kilogram. Okay, so if this comes to the numerator, Kelvin mole inverse kilogram. So this will be my unit for Kf. Okay, now molality value we have to find and we have to substitute in equation number 1. So what is molality? Number of moles of the solute divided by number of moles of the solute divided by mass of solvent in kilograms. Yes or no? So number of moles of the solute means solute is my second component. So N2 divided by mass of the solvent. Mass means W, solvent means 1, in kilogram means divided by 1000. Same way how we did boiling point. So number of moles, what is the formula? Mass by molar mass. So number of moles of 2 means mass of 2 divided by molar mass of 2. So if I substitute this here, I will get m is equal to W2 by M2 divided by W1 by 1000. So m is equal to W2 by M2. If it goes this side, this will become 1000 by W1. So this I will keep it as equation 2. Now I am going to substitute 2 in 1. So I will get delta Tf is equal to Kf into m means W2 into 1000 divided by m2 into W1. We need m2 value only, so bring m2 this side, Tf this side. m2 is equal to Kf into W2 into 1000 divided by delta Tf into W1. So this is my formula to calculate the molar mass of the solute. Okay, so this also I can represent it with the help of the graph. In x axis I will take temperature in Kelvin, and in the y axis I will take vapor pressure. So which will have more freezing point? Solvent will have more freezing point, solution will be having less freezing point. So for the solvent, the freezing point will be like this, and for the solution, the freezing point will be like this. Okay, so I can choose a point here. So this will be my Tf. Similarly, if I choose a point here, this will be my Tf naught. So this difference will be my delta Tf, that is Tf naught minus Tf. Okay, so how will you can find this as a slope. Okay, so now So this will be my graph. So I hope you understood these three things. So the remaining things we will continue in the next class.